Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to take a look at meso compounds. So meso compounds are a special class of stereoisomers where that's an achiral molecule, but it has chiral centers in it. And that's because it has a line of symmetry throughout the molecule, and that makes it superimposable with its mirror image, and so achiral. So let's look at an example of the type of molecule you might see that would look like this. So I'm going to draw this example here. I have these two carbon atoms that have bromines coming off of them, and those carbons have four unique groups around them. So they are indeed chiral themselves. So if we did the priorities, right, bromine would be the highest priority. And then if I went around the ring to the right, I would get to that bromine first. So this carbon here would be my second priority. Then going this would be my third. And then the H going back would be my fourth, right? So if I went in a circle there, I'd be going clockwise, so that's R. If I did my priorities here, 1, 2, 3. So in this case, I'd be going counterclockwise, so that's gonna be S. So both of those carbons are chiral there, and I'm just gonna redraw this without the stereochemistry assignments drawn on there so we can see it a little bit better. But you can see that there is a line of symmetry right down the center of this molecule. It's like a mirror plane, right? And because of that mirror plane, it's actually superimposable with its stereoisomer, its enantiomer, and because of that, it's achiral. So let's look at another example here, and this time we'll look at a chain so we can see how it can freely rotate. But sometimes, you know, what looks like it might have symmetry, you have to put it in kind of the most symmetrical orientation in order to check. So for this example, both of those OHs are sticking out, but you see how my methyl groups aren't lined up with one another? So if I rotate so that the carbon chain is sort of in the most symmetrical orientation it could be, so I'm going to rotate 180 degrees is what I'll do around this. So I'm just going to leave the left-hand side alone. But when I rotate 180 degrees, this methyl group here is now going to be sticking down. And then this OH group is going to be sticking back because I've rotated it 180 degrees. And it's always a little bit hard with 3D stereochemistry. So if you want to follow along and build yourself a model, that's a good way to check, you know, that you believe me when I'm rotating about that bond. So you can see now that when I'm in this very symmetrical orientation, my methyls line up, but my OHs don't. So this is not a meso compound because it doesn't have a plane of symmetry down the middle of it. Okay, so this would be a chiral molecule with chiral stereocenters. However, if we look at another stereoisomer of this molecule, so the one where in the kind of classic zigzag orientation, I have one OH out and one OH back, again, if I rotate 180 degrees here, now you can see that going about that bond, those are exactly lined up. So my methyls are in the same orientation. They're just in line with one another. My OHs are both sticking out in the same orientation. And then those assumed hydrogens are going back. So again, I have this plane of symmetry right down the middle of that. And so this is an example of a meso compound. Okay, it is superimposable with its mirror image because of that plane of symmetry, whereas the one on the top wouldn't be. Okay, so this is a little bit of a follow-along type thing if you want to prove to yourself by making a model that this is true about meso compounds. So if you get yourself a four-carbon chain, and then you can just put whatever kind of ball you want on there that are the same, right? Because you have two X groups coming off. We're calling them OHs. So I'm going to draw these molecules with their mirror images, okay? So these two would be enantiomers of one another because they are mirror images of one another, okay? But if you build these two molecules the way that they're oriented, now they look the same, right? But if I flipped one over 180 degrees so that my methyl groups were lining up, then the OHs would be going back, okay? So they're actually opposite one another. Let's prove this by doing the stereochemistry assignment. So we've got 1, 2, and 3, right? So this guy would be R. And then 1, 2, and 3. So this guy would be S, okay? And then 1, 2, and 3. So now I'm going counterclockwise. So S, which is opposite, right? And then I've got 1, 2, and 3. So that would be R. So see how they're exactly opposite of one another? They are enantiomers of one another. But if you build these two, you'll see that you can actually get them to superimpose over one another, right? Which you can't do for a chiral molecule. So these are both meso compounds. Here is my plane of symmetry. There's my mirror right there, right? Now, if you really want to prove this to yourself, you can look at the other two possible stereoisomers. So where one OH is up and one OH is down. Okay, so these also are enantiomers of one another. So like this bottom set, this is a set of enantiomers, okay? So we know sort of from our stereochemistry up here, this one would be R because it looks the same as the top one above it. And then this is opposite of the top one, so that would be R. And then these guys will be SS, okay? So they are enantiomers of one another, but they are non-superimposable. So if you build these two molecules and you try to superimpose them, you can't. Okay, and that is the thing about chiral molecules. They are non-superimposable mirror images of one another. Okay. Okay, so that's an example of how to prove to yourself, right, that these are non-superimposable. Sometimes it helps to actually see it. In practice, though, if you're just looking at a structure on a piece of paper, you can identify that line of symmetry by lining the molecule up in the kind of the most symmetrical orientation. For a meso compound, there'll be a plane of symmetry right down the middle, you know, somewhere in the middle that negates that chirality, even though there are chiral atoms. And for a compound that's not meso, you won't have that. So for these bottom two compounds, there is no line of symmetry throughout the molecule, no plane of symmetry, and so they're not meso compounds. This has been a look at how to identify meso compounds and what they are. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.